Thank you. I'll have the answer shortly.
Of course,
I knew I would be able to solve it.
Should do it, I think. And that's how it's done.
Blimey, this is hard work. See? I get 'em right sometimes.
Is an interesting one. Puzzles are made for solving.
Thank you.
This is an interesting one. And that's how it's done.
Thank you.
Blimey, this is hard work. See? I'll get them right sometimes.
If you'll entertain my idea here. That's a relief. I wasn't entirely sure.
So what? There's some elaborate plot going on here behind the scenes? Is that what you're saying, Kat?
It's evident that the criminal is both extremely intelligent and a level-headed decision-maker. It can't possibly be him.
You're right. Level-headed, intelligent, an expert, in fact, on everything about this ship.
Thank you.
Look, I think. Not a bad look, I think. Thank you.
Blimey, this is hard work. The pieces just fell into place somehow.
I've seen how to solve this now. Any mystery or any puzzle solved.
Thank you.
Do it, I think. Any mystery or any puzzle solved.
Thank you.
This should do it, I think. Puzzles are made for solving.
Thank you.
For whom the goddess smiles. Well, she would love each and every one of us equally, of course. Yet there is someone among us who would have her all for himself. And that someone is... No, wait. I think everyone's more interested in where the goddess is rather than who is responsible for her disappearance. So...
Hold it. Everyone knows it's bad guy first, then how he did it.
Yes, I should bow to my audience's wishes and explain the whereabouts of the statue first.
Hello, dog giving advice here.
So, where is the statue, you ask? The truth is, it was stolen by someone, but I have deduced where that someone has hidden it.
Stolen?
How could that be?
Yeah, we're talking about a 4-ton statue here. How could anyone make off with that? Even if it was possible to move it, there's no way to get it off the boat.
But there is. There's one way you could get the statue off this boat and onto dry land.
How exactly?
I'll tell you. Even as we speak, the goddess of... Shore. The statue is under the water, being dragged along by the boat as we speak. And the thief is planning to recover the statue once the party is over and we've docked at the wharf.
But who would do such a thing?
There's only one person who could have done this, and that is you. Captain Midas Pullman. And all of the crew have been helping you. You've taken a hallowed image, bound it, and mercilessly thrust it into the, let's face it, grim waters of the Thames estuary. It's nothing short of sacrilege. You are all guilty of anchor abuse.
Anchor abuse? On the Titanic? Unthinkable.
That's not a thing, Cat. Reel it back in now.
Thank you.
It's all over. The case is closed. The ship's captain tried to steal the statue and the old crew were in on it, but they didn't get away with it. It's under the vessel, boys. Fetch it out.
Sir! Under the vessel!
You greedy, good-for-nothing spalpeen! You're not fit to call yourself a man of the sea!
I'm not so sure. I believe it was the captain's undying love of the sea that drove him to such lengths.
Love?
Mr. Pullman is aboard this brand new ship today because he is employed as its captain. But once upon a time, he himself owned one of the most famous luxury vessels around, the SS Midas Touch. Isn't that right?
How did you...
Sadly, your business met with hard times in the economic recession, and you were forced to sell your ship and lay off all of her crew. You put all your younger years into that ship, and now you want her back, don't you?
Yes, you're right. You've certainly done your homework, I'll give you that.
Unbelievable.
I met my late wife aboard that ship. She means everything to me. I poured my soul into her.
This crew who are conspiring with you, they're the crew from your old ship, correct?
Yes, and I knew doing a terrible thing like this would mean I wasn't worthy of her. But I just had to get her back, by fair means or foul.
Midas, you realize that I have acquired the Midas Touch through one of my brokers.
What? Really? You own her, Mr. Fullhold?
I do.
But I don't understand. I didn't think you were interested in older vessels.
No. Those crusty old ships make no money, but the Midas Touch is different. She is in a class of her own. If you want a pinnacle of luxury, there is no greater boat on the water. I have decided to run two cruise services from now on. These more affordable ones, and a Pullman service.
Really? I don't know what to say.
Once you have made amends for this little transgression, I was thinking of making you captain of the Midas Touch. She will be fully refurbished, of course. What do you say?
Do you mean that?
Yes. No one knows how to get the best from her, like you.
There's nothing I'd rather do.
Well, Captain Pullman, that's all worked out rather swimmingly, hasn't it?
Thanks to you, Miss Layton. The business plan you produced for the Midas Touch was very impressive.
You old dog cat! You arranged all this!
Brilliant, Miss Layton! You solved the mystery and put everything right at the same time.
Oh, well, it's what I do.
Thank you.
This analysis would be simplicity itself. Of course, I knew I would be able to solve it.
So, in conclusion, that's a relief. I wasn't entirely sure.